Hey everyone, welcome to .NET Techie. This is Deep Gautam here, and it's time to learn something very special, because when I tried to test Angular HTTP services, I got this error, and you might be facing this error. This is very common error which you will facing when you are writing the unit test cases for Angular HTTP services. So if you are making a RESTful call in your Angular application and you want to write the test cases for those services, first thing you will get this error. What is that error? Error says static injector error, dynamic test module. It says it cannot find HTTP client module. You are injecting something which is null injector, no provider for HTTP client. So it's high time to first resolve this error, then only we can write the test cases, right? So what I thought, let's first resolve this error, show you how to resolve this error. There are many people who ask in the Google, and unfortunately no one has given the right solution in order to resolve this static injector error. So what I thought, let's first give the solution of this, then we will proceed for Angular unit testing of HTTP services. So before I head towards the solution, I would like to just mention over here what you will learn in this lesson. So you will learn error, static injector error, dynamic testing module. So when you are trying to test HTTP services, and whatever the code test cases you have got in spec file, it will give this error. And second thing, I will tell you how to run single test file in Angular. Third thing, I will run how to run single test case in Angular. All right, so let's see what is my code. So let us see, if I want to test my product service dot specs, the default code which I'm having is this one. All right, so this is my default code which I'm having one test case over here, right? And it is failing because of the reason static injector error. All right, so what is that? Why it is happening like that? It says that, okay, you have included testbed, you are configuring testing module and you are providing product service. But note down, what product service is needed? Product service is needed one HTTP module. Why product service is needed HTTP module? First of all, it is making a RESTful call. Second thing, in the constructor we have given HTTP client, so it says that, okay, you are asking me to create the instance of product service class, but you have not given me HTTP. All right, so how to resolve this error? In order to make the things speedy, what I have done, I have already written test cases, and which I will tell you, it's a very simple thing and you will be able to work on it, resolve on it. All right, so first let's see the result, and then I will talk about what is the solution and how it works. All right, so let me collapse this as well. Okay, this is just executed one of one. Okay, executed one of one, success. All right, let's see. Say the HTTP client testing should be created product service. So it has created the instance of product service. How it has created the product service instance, what we have done, imported the HTTP client testing module which is there in common HTTP testing. That's why, because we haven't imported this thing in earlier version, that's why we were getting the error. We need HTTP client as well, we need HTTP testing module as well. Then in describe, what we did, we have created instance of HTTP client, HTTP testing controller. Then before executing any test case in the testbed.configuration.testing module, we have imported HTTP client testing module, which will provide HTTP client before service gets initialized. So before any service operation, this HTTP client is available But when we are calling product service, then HTTP client is available and it is not giving the error. That's what the solution of this error. So you can look at my code closely. I can show you, it says should be created product service. All right. So here, till now, we worked on this particular point, error static injector. Right. How to run single test file in Angular, that I will show you. Just go to the solution. If you want to work one by one in the test file, find out your test.ts, which is the configuration file for running test cases. By default, you will see this line of the code. All right, this says that you find out all .spec.ts file and run the test cases for them. Then we will find all test cases. It has written in the commented part. All right, now what I wanted to test my product service itself. I do not want anything else to be tested. All right, so what I did, instead of asking for find out all .spec file, I said that okay, run the test case for this particular file. That's how we can run single test file in Angular. Okay, so that's the one of the easiest way which I found and we should be using. All right, so let's see what else we can achieve. All right, so just hold on. Okay, so now what we want, let's put another test case over here and test what's happening. So it should be, let's say created, we will say this as 1 and this we will say as 2. Let's see what's happening. All right, we did, and what's the result? It's coming up, it's still executing. It said should be created 1 and should be created 2. All right, let's see if we say X over here, what's happening? All right, so we saved it and it has executed, is still executing, and it will say 2 specs, 0 failure, 1 pending. So what we did, only 1 we have tested and 1 we have avoided. All right, it will say F over here, you will see some different result. And this is still executing and result is what? 1 specs, ran 1 of 2. So it is avoiding other, only running 1. This one should be created 2. All right, so it says should be created 2. That's what we have done in this tutorial. So finally, if I will show you what you have learned now is the very important information which I tried to make to learn. And this is what we have learned, is how to resolve static injector error in Angular HTTP services. So this is your learning, sorry for that here. So now you are well versed how to create the HTTP client, because you are able to resolve this error. This was very painful error. Even I was facing the problem, so I thought let's give the solution of this problem, then we will proceed further in our next lesson. And in my earlier lesson, we have tested the Angular component. Now we tried to test Angular HTTP services, where we have created the instance of HTTP services. So in our next lesson, I will go in more detail about HTTP service testing. Before testing HTTP services, I met with this error and I tried to Google it. There was very hard solution for that. So I thought let's give something easy solution to you and move further. Thank you for watching this video. Please comment your question. I will be happy to answer. If you require any source code, yeah, I'm okay to give the source code as well. Thank you for watching.